Hi, I will demonstrate how Virsec Cybersecurity Control VSP protects Apache ActiveMQ against the remote code execution vulnerability CVE-2023-46604 that CISA reported as being heavily exploited last week. Here are the CVE details. As you can see, the exploit is a remote code execution attack on Apache ActiveMQ version 5.18.3 and below. The CVE has a base score of 10, making it a critical vulnerability. In this attack kill chain, at step 1, the threat actor performs reconnaissance to check if the workload is vulnerable to the RC vulnerability CVE-2023-46604. Once the threat actor determines the workload is vulnerable, they execute a persistence exploit at step 3. The exploit installs a backdoor that helps the threat actor gain remote control of the victim's workload. From step 7 to 10, the attacker can execute any malicious actions such as executing late-stage precompiled and LOLBin malware that will exfiltrate data, execute lateral movement, rinse and repeat malicious actions on adjacent workloads, etc. Virsec VSP protects the workload early in the kill chain before the threat actor can execute any malicious actions. Let us explore the attack with VSP running in detect mode. In this mode, we will see all the steps the threat actor will carry out. VSP will log all the threat actor actions. Later, we will explore the attack in VSP's protect mode, where the threat actor will be blocked very early in the kill chain. Let us get back to the detect mode demo. We can see from the CMS dashboard that the Apache ActiveMQ server is protected by VSP running in detect mode. We can see that the Apache ActiveMQ server is protected by a few pre-configured application control rules that have hardened the server and only permit legitimate actions. This mechanism implements Virsec's protection principle of default deny allow trusted. One set of rules deny execution of pre-configured LOLBin such as bash, CSH, AWK, etc. by default. Another set of rules enumerate all the command lines that the Apache ActiveMQ server will legitimately execute as it operates. The server is currently set in the detect state so that we can show the impact of the exploit. Now let us view the incident page in the VSP dashboard. As you can see, there have been no incidents reported yet. On the left-hand side of the screen, we see the threat actor's server, which I have hosted at the IP address 10.27.203. On the right-hand side is the Apache ActiveMQ server that I have hosted at the IP address 10.47.7.66. The threat actor can deploy a reverse shell script in this path after successfully executing the exploit. As you notice from the output of the ls command, there are no files with the name refshell.sh currently in this folder. Now let us check the version of ActiveMQ. We can see from the output that it is running a vulnerable version of 5.18.0. Let us run the pst command on the victim to check if the Apache ActiveMQ server is operational. As you can see, the Apache ActiveMQ server is operating normally. The persistent exploit script on the threat actor machine needs the IP address and the port of the Apache ActiveMQ server and the IP where the threat actor hosted the malicious XML file. Let's explore the sequence of events when the threat actor executes the exploit. First, the exploit runs an nmap scan to check if a port 61616 is open and running ActiveMQ service. It also retrieves the version information and verifies whether it is vulnerable. Once the threat actor determines that the app suffers from the vulnerability identified by CVE-2023-46604, the threat actor proceeds to leverage the CVE. It uses a LOLBin called curl to download a malicious bash reverse shell script onto the victim's server. After this step, the exploit invokes the uploaded script to establish remote control. A netcat server is spawned on the threat actor's machine, listening for a backdoor connection from the victim's server. As soon as the backdoor becomes active, we gain control over the victim's machine. At this point, the netcat server has connected successfully to the victim's server. Now examining the ActiveMQ's process tree, we notice a malicious backdoor bash command running as a child process of one of Java's worker threads. This backdoor represents a remote SSH session from which the threat actor can execute arbitrary commands on the target workload. At this point, the threat actor pawns the victim machine. Let us run an ifconfig command on the threat actor server. As we can see, the IP address reported by the ifconfig is the IP address of the victim server. Now the threat actor can execute the cat command on the etc password file to display the contents of the password file. Upon inspecting ActiveMQ's bin folder, we can see the bash reversal script called refshell.sh deposited by the attacker. Let's go back to the CMS dashboard. Here we see that we have received several incidents of the attack. The first ticket notifies the enterprise about the backdoor used in the attack. We can also see the details of the RC attack. The following ticket provides information about the chmod command and the curl command used in the attack and other RC attack details. Next, we can see a ticket for the ifconfig and the cat command used. Now let us rerun the attack, but VSP will be in protect mode this time. When running in protect mode, the threat actor should have zero dwell time. Let me enable protect mode for the ActiveMQ server. I will also enable a protection profile that will terminate any malicious command that may execute. Now let us view the incident page in the VSP dashboard. As you can see, there have been no incidents reported yet. Now upon inspecting the bin folder, we do not see any refshell.sh file yet. Let me run the ps3 command once again. You can see that no backdoor bash process are currently executing as a child of the Java process. Now let me run the exploit once again. The threat actor console that the network connection has timed out, indicating that the exploit failed to execute on the vulnerable Apache ActiveMQ server. Upon checking the PS3 on the victim server, I couldn't find any backdoor bash command under the Java process. This indicates that Virsec has successfully blocked the RC exploit. Furthermore, upon inspecting the bin folder, I noticed the absence of refshell.sh file, which confirms that the exploit failed as Virsec effectively blocked the RCE. Now let's go back to the CMS dashboard. We see an incident for the attack. In the first incident, Virsec's VSP successfully blocked the backdoor established via the bash command used in the attack. We can see all the details of the RCE attack. We can also see the protection actions carried out by Virsec to prevent the attack. We can see that the attacker could not launch any arbitrary code of their choosing. By blocking the attacker's ability to execute any code, Virsec's VSP achieves true protection that detect and respond technologies can't even aspire for. This demo shows that Virsec can protect a vulnerable app that enterprise IoT has not patched with zero dwell time. Thank you.